Hi, I'm Dr. John Kugler with the Stanford 25 Ultrasound Series. Today we're going to get started with our first ultrasound scan. So getting started, we first need to define our clinical question. So in point-of-care ultrasound, it's really important to ask a narrowly focused clinical question, and one that you feel confident you can answer. So a really good clinical question might be, for this patient, do they have a left-sided pleural effusion? That's a yes or no kind of answer. It's there or it isn't. And that's something I feel like I can confidently answer. What would be a less good question? Why does this patient have abdominal pain? Why do they have chest pain? These are very general questions. If I were to just start scanning the patient to answer a general question like that, there's a good chance I'm going to see something that I don't know what to do with, and next thing you know, I'm subjecting him to more additional radiology scans that he otherwise might not need. So make sure, before you grab the probe, think about what clinical question you need to answer. Now let's go ahead and get the probe. So for today, before you even start scanning, we need to make sure we've got everything set up. So I'm going to go ahead and adjust my bed. So we want to save our backs, so let's move the bed up a little bit, okay? The next thing I would normally do is I'm going to darken the room. Now, because we're shooting a video, we're going to keep it bright in here. But it really does help to get the room a little bit darker. It's going to help you to see the ultrasound screen better. Next, I'm going to go ahead and put some gel on my probe, and I'm going to position my patient. Now, today we have a healthy patient who has no problem moving, but you know, if you're working with older patients, sicker patients, you actually may need to help them move in bed. But now I'm just going to have my patient just go ahead and take your left arm and put it behind your head. Perfect. I'm going to grab the probe, and I'm going to show you all how to hold this. Now, many early ultrasonographers, they want to hold it like a microphone, okay? They want to hold it like this. In fact, I think the companies, they design these probes to look very ergonomic, so you want to hold it like this. But this is not the correct way to hold it. You're going to have a lot of trouble manipulating the probe appropriately. So what I'm going to encourage you all to do is hold it like you would hold a pencil, all right? That way you can move the probe much easier. Now, the next thing that a lot of people have trouble with is when they go to apply the probe to your patient. What we're going to do here is we're going to place the probe on our patient, and notice my hand, I'm going to put the whole side of my hand against his side so it doesn't go anywhere. Again, a lot of people when they start out, they hold the probe back here, they don't touch the patient, right? And so now they're like this, but their attention's over here on the screen, right? And so they're staring at the screen, and next thing you know, the whole thing's moved, right? And it's because the gel is really slippery. You don't know that you've moved. So scoot up, again, like it's a pencil. Put your hand against the patient like so, and now we can get a nice, clear picture. Now, the first thing you're going to do is you need to know some movements. So when you place the probe on the patient, you're going to slide around a little bit, right? So you're sliding until you've got a picture that you like, right? So now I can say, okay, I've got a nice picture here. I like my picture. Now I'm not going to move it. I'm going to anchor my hand, and now I can do my other movements. So first, there's fanning the probe. That's when we move perpendicular to the beam, right? This is fanning. I'm going to go anterior, posterior, back and forth, okay? Then there's rocking the probe, all right? When you rock the probe, you're going to move parallel to the direction of your beam. So in this case, I want to look up into the chest, so I'm going to rock and send the beam further superior into the chest, okay? I can also rock inferior if I wanted to. And then finally, you can rotate the probe, which is pretty self-explanatory. You rotate, or you can compress when you just push down. Those are going to be your the different motions that you need to do. So now that you know all that, you're ready to actually go ahead and look for a pleural effusion.